Hello, translators. So this is for all of you who are just starting out, all of you translators who are just getting going and you're maybe wondering how to set up and where exactly to go with this and how to start out as a translator, because this is a question that I get very often from beginners, and it has to do with specializations. Pretty soon you'll realize, okay, I should be translating from Italian to English, right? And you're like, okay, fine. But a couple issues will come up. First of all, you'll think, well, I've never translated Italian to English before. I've never done it for a client. You know, you have the chicken and the egg problem. I've never had a client before. How do I get my first client? Because everyone wants someone with experience. Well, to handle that really is, in fact, I've noticed a lot of times what's just as important as experience in translation, or many times even more important, is experience in the specialization. So maybe you've never officially translated Italian to English, but you have worked as a paralegal and as a lawyer, both in Italy and the US in two different languages. Maybe you worked, say, as a paralegal in an American firm in Italy, and you've translated back and forth for them, and you've looked at contracts in both languages, stuff like that. Well, that's very valuable to a client. In fact, many times that's more valuable to someone who studied translation and then just decides to tackle legal translation for the first time, because you know the terminology and you kind of can speak with the terminology fluently in both languages, while the other translator can't, because they're not sure, oh, wait a minute, you know, how do I translate? Is statuto, is it statute, or is it articles of association? Or is it bylaws? Or, by the way, statuto is not statute when you're dealing with articles of association or bylaws. It's one or the other. But anyway, and that's the thing. A lot of things that might seem obvious are not, if you know the specialization a bit better and you've been through it. So I want to talk a bit about specialization. So how do you decide what your specialization is? Well, precisely that. You see where you've had experience. If you've worked before, that pretty much is your specialization. You know, if you've been working in the legal field, that's your specialization. If you've been working in business field, that's your specialization. Or else if you studied something, then that should probably be your specialization. Look, I'm not saying you're going to be an expert right off the bat on how to translate back and forth, but I am saying that you probably have experience in both languages. If you already speak both languages, you've probably looked at least a bit in both languages, and it's probably been in that specialization. So that's where you should probably be concentrating on. So say you studied marketing. You're a French person and you studied marketing in the States. So you know the marketing terminology in English, but chances are you know it in French too, because, I mean, you need to know what they mean by market segmentation. So you look it up and in French, you'd be like, oh, okay, that's the word. I'm not saying you're not going to have to look into it and maybe find a couple websites and places where you can find the right terminology and read up a bit. But at least you have an avenue to follow. And marketing can be your specialization, because you do have some experience in those. And so ultimately, you know, that's what you should do. If you're wondering what your specialization should be, maybe you have a passion for poetry. Okay. But if you have experience in something, definitely add that. You know, maybe later you can look into adding another passion you have that you don't have experience in. But I think where you have the most experience in right now, that is going to be where you will find your jobs and where you find most success. Because, like it or leave it, you're going to have some experience in both languages if you've studied, and especially if you've worked in that field. And that was the case for me. I worked in finance. I worked in a bank. I studied in the US and went to college in the US after growing up in Switzerland. Then I went back to Switzerland and I worked in a bank there. Everything's in Italian. But obviously, anytime an English-speaking client comes, I'm dealing with them. So I'm dealing with my boss, everything's in Italian. Then with the client, everything in English, talking about the same things. So suddenly, even before having really translated, because back then I wasn't a translator, I had no intention of being a translator, but I knew how to talk about commodity trade finance in both languages with no problem. I can talk about everything you have to do with the shipping, the free on board, bills of lading, stuff like that, and all the different types of commodities, especially metals, non-ferrous metals. I can talk about that in both languages, no problem. And that's kind of where that started and how I got my start. Look into your own past and what you have some experience in. I'm not saying you won't have to build up on that, because you definitely will. Because I went from that, and then I went into legal translations, which took work on my part. Yeah. Anyway, I don't have to get into that. But it was. I'm not saying it won't take work, but at least it gives you an avenue to start. And I find a lot of people, when they're first starting, they're not sure where to start. And you know, because kind of specialization sort of crept up on them, they weren't even sure how that gets decided or where that falls into. And so, yeah, look into your own past, see what you have experience in. Whatever you have experience in is probably the avenue you should pursue. And so pursue that avenue, whatever that might be for you. Whether you read up a bit more or work on, in that field a bit more, or like I always say, translation, you can always practice it. You can go to a website and just start translating yourself and see what comes up. And if the website's already been translated, all the better. Translate it, then look at the translation they have and see how you did compared to that. Hey, you never know. You might do a better job than they have there, in which case you can already contact them. Maybe you get your first client, you know? But that's the way to find a specialization, I feel. If you're first starting out, I think that's a good a way as any, quite frankly, because you're going to find out what you have experience in and just move forward from there. So, yeah, hopefully you can find this useful, especially if you're first starting out and you're looking for your specialization. Please feel free to let me know if you have any other way of finding your specialization, because I'd be interested to hear about it. But yeah, that's pretty much it for now. And otherwise, I will talk to you next time. Sabedum.